Hi guys, this is Katie Bunschoten, the president and founder of Certum Solutions, a business automation and accounting practice outside of Charlotte, North Carolina. And today I wanted to go over a question that I got recently from one of our clients. Within QuickBooks Enterprise Contractor Edition, you can actually complete change orders. Within QuickBooks Online, as our construction clients are moving over, a lot of times that's not possible without a third-party add-on. So what I'm going to talk about today in brief is how to do change orders in QuickBooks Online if you do not have a third-party add-on. I'm going to go through a really quick workaround, and then we're actually going to do a demo of one of our third-party add-ons this afternoon, but there are several that you can go with, so I want to make sure everybody knows if you have questions around what you can use to do a more formal change order process, reach out to us, okay? Before I go in too deep to this topic, you know what I'm going to say. If you like the kind of content that we have on the Certum Solutions channel, make sure that you subscribe to our channel. If you like this particular video and you'd like to see more like it, make sure you like this video itself. That's how you vote and how you engage with us. If you'd like more information about anything we talk about on our channel, go ahead and schedule your free custom Q&A, and we would love to talk to you more. I am not our construction expert, but I have done construction, bookkeeping, and accounting for several years. We have some talented construction experts on our team, and one of which you will get to meet soon. But for today, we have our QuickBooks Enterprise or QuickBooks Online Advanced demo file. I always use our advanced file for my videos and demos. If you don't see a feature in your version, I know like Plus is very popular and so on, then it might be something you need to upgrade for. Make sure you reach out to us for that. We can take care of you there too. Okay, so this is our, let's see here, let's go to our dashboard. This is our QuickBooks Online Advanced Demo Dashboard. So if you look in the left-hand navigation, we're going to be working in projects today, okay? Prior to working in projects, you need to go over to your accountant settings in the right top gear, and you need to click over, let's double check, I believe it's in advanced. Let's go and double check that. I might be wrong. No, it's not advanced. Let's try sales. Let's see. Okay. Oh, yes. You need to make sure progress invoicing is on. So that's under your sales piece, but that's only one part of it. Whenever we're working in construction and we're doing like an estimate and we're building our invoices off of that estimate, a lot of times we need that progress invoicing function. So that's one thing you want to turn on. But what I'm actually looking for is turning on, I need to turn on our projects function, which I thought it was under advanced, but it's not shown. Ah, it was under advanced. I tricked myself. Not the first time. So make sure you go to the advanced tab and you hit the little pencil to the right and you turn on projects as well. Okay. So I'm going to X out of there because both of those things are done. So let's go ahead and click on our projects button. And I have starred or favorited the project we're working in today. Why'd I do that? Because we have a lot of projects in this file, and Lord knows who's been in there recently to play around. I wanted to make sure that we had this one highlighted. So if you're like us and you have several projects that you're working on, but you have those particular ones that you need to get on frequently, just click the little star to the left of it and it will highlight it at the top of the screen. So we're going to click on the test icon or on the project icon, and I'm going to click over here to transactions. You can see that we have created some estimates here. Okay, so this one right here is pending. We have another one here that's pending. And I'm going to go ahead and click on this estimate, and I'm going to make sure that I make it active. So somebody accepted it because they love us and they want to work with us. You can see up here in the top right that on the estimate, we have our estimated profit margin, our estimated costs, and our estimated income. All this is really great for simple contractors that really don't have a ton of complexity and you need that basic information at your fingertips. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and hit save and close. Okay, so now we have our estimate saved. It's not going to show income yet because you haven't invoiced anything, okay? But you can run an estimate versus actuals report. where it will say, here's your estimated cost, here's your actual cost, here's the difference between the cost that you've entered on this project and any percent difference. And all these are funny numbers. They're not going to make a whole ton of sense. It's just so I can show you the program. It will also show you your estimated income based off of the estimates that you've already entered, okay? Just for a refresher, right? Estimates, purchase orders, sales orders are non-posting transactions in QuickBooks, so it's not going to affect your profit and loss, but they will show up on your project reporting. Okay, so we've got that estimate done, and so we've done an estimate, say, and for some reason, say the estimate is with George. George has decided he wants to make a change. You have a couple things you can do. If you want to add an additional estimate to the project, you can certainly do that. Say, you know what, I wanted you to remodel my house, but now I also want you to redo my deck. Okay, you can do additional change orders, no problem, just create a new estimate. However, what if, hey, I asked you to remodel my house, but I want to take some things away. I need to change the original order, but it's not really an add-on, it's just adjusting the original order, right? Well, shoot, how do we do that? We don't want to do a negative estimate. So what we're going to do is, say that we need 100 hours, we had 100 hours of labor, and we want to change that to 50. I'm going to go ahead and change the live project estimate in here. Okay. Now follow me on this journey. It's not perfect, but for a lot of people, this is a sufficient to run, you know, a simplified project costing piece for your contractor company or for your construction company. When you click more, you can then see your audit history. The audit history can show you all the changes that you have made to this estimate. So if the question is, okay, great, I did a change order, I sent the new order to the customer. However, how do I see what the original change or what the original estimate was for? That's when you use your audit trail. Okay, so you can go ahead and you hit show all, and it shows you all the changes that have occurred on this transaction, and it highlights the fields that were changed in yellow. Once again, I have trouble. I'm tripping over my words, but y'all know me by now. Anyway, so we've gone ahead and made this change. You can see that's reflecting here. If you want to do like a screenshot or print this out, you can print it. Sometimes it looks a little bit basic. You can see there you've just got like your Times New Roman. Didn't know anybody still used that. It's the source font. But you can print that out, or you can take screenshots of it and provide it to your customer for a full audit history of the change orders on your project. However, if you have a more complex construction company and you need a very formal change order process, reach out to us. We can go through several partners that plug right into QuickBooks Online and we'll give you the features and functions that you need. Thank you so much for being patient with me during this very short demo of how to do a change order in QuickBooks Online if you want a workaround. And if you have questions or you want to talk about it more, let me know. I don't know if you saw it, but I have an appointment to go over our next video on Builder Trend, which is one of the solutions we talk about for the change order process. And I have to get going to that appointment. So thank you so much. And I look forward to hearing from you guys. And thanks again for watching. Bye-bye.